Hi friends, hope everyone's doing well. This side, Tanvi with you today. And today we will learn about the thermal loss in solar PV panel and how to determine the loss in Pvsyst. This is our fifth session in Pvsyst system loss calculation series. Please watch other videos in this series as well to have a complete idea on PV system loss. And for the new viewer who are here for the first time, please hit the subscribe and like button. We will keep bringing such useful and resourceful content to you every week. So please subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified. Thank you guys for your support so far. Your likes and comments meant a lot for us. So let us begin the session. When you start system design in Pvsyst, after assigning the Mateo data orientation and completing the configuration of system with PV module and inverter, the next step is to determine and assign values to various system losses. When you open the detail loss window in Pvsyst, the first loss type is thermal loss, named as thermal parameters in Pvsyst. Here you can see that Pvsyst has already set a predetermined value as default. Now to change and suit your project requirement, you have three options to choose from. This is under the subsection of default value according to mounting. First one is pre-mounted modules with air circulation. This means the normal ground-mounted or rooftop installation as shown in the pictures. This is the very common type of installation around the world. Next is semi-integrated with air duct behind. What it means is that an external arrangement to naturally or forcefully blow air at the backside of PV module, so that it'll lose temperature by convection and temperature will be lower. This type is very rare nowadays as it adds up capital investment. And the energy gain from such arrangement is not attractive comparing to the complexity and cost of this arrangement. The third option is integration with fully insulated back, where you install the modules at the mounting surface, without leaving any significant gap between the two planes. This refers to tilted rooftop installation mostly as shown here in the pictures. Now, select any of these options that describe best for your PV module mountings. Don't change the values in formulae section unless you know the values well. And don't change anything in this NOCT area. Just keep it as it is. Now, we have selected all these three options for three separate simulations to show you the result. So, as you can see here, the temperature loss is highest when you mount modules with back insulated. Upon selecting the second option, the loss is lesser but still very high. And if you install module as free mounted, then the temperature loss is the lowest. Hope you get the basic idea of thermal loss in solar panels and how to assign them in Pvsyst according to the mounting. Our next session will be on the ohmic loss or cable loss in Pvsyst. So keep subscribed and enjoy the learning process. Do not forget to like, comment and share this session. To follow our channel Minutes to Energy on YouTube and Instagram for more upcoming and interesting videos on solar PV system. Like how to start a solar business, how to design solar PV system and solar panel manufacturing process. Thanks for watching. See you in the next session.